So that kept me on my toes. I must say, I had to really think about those sharp corners in the Alpha Flies.
Hunting time trial day. Let's rock and roll.
It's a big day.
Let's do this.
Big day.
It's gonna be in Irving, Texas. Not there.
Oh.
Nice to be home.
It's nice to be home.
It's nice to be home.
Yeah.
So here we go. 13.1.
Oh, is that what it is today?
13.1 miles.
Oh, you're gonna
half
crash.
Half marathon. True Love did a half marathon.
Whoa, back in the day.
Back in the day in Utah.
Back when we were dating.
Pulled
the old baby switch.
Crashed it. Oh, but we got big plans coming up.
Yeah, we do.
Oh, that is not the idea, though, that we talked about yesterday. Jake, you see that? What is it? Try and jump our fence. Interesting. I gotta explore that more. The nice thing about a time trial, everybody, is you start whenever you want, you know? No starting gun. Oh, man. And it's a little chilly, so I'm going to let the sun come up a little bit more before we get rolling. Okay. And I did just see, sadly, so I was supposed to race in Irving, Texas today, and it looks like it's pretty windy down there today, so who knows? Oh, my goodness. I'm just grateful for the day. And, yes, I am taking out the Nike Alpha Fly Next Percents as I continue to test them for all of you. All right, let's rock and roll. Cherry Creek Trail, cheers. Okay, taking out the glycerins for the warm-up, and yes, I'm gonna put down a Morton right now. Before the warm-up, I like to get it in my body, in my stomach, about 45 minutes before I get going, whether it's on a race day or in a time trial like today. So I'm going to put this back right now. Lovely, lovely taste in this guy. Water, glucose, fructose, calcium carbonate, glucose, acid, sodium alginate. Woo! Got the racing socks out today. Yes, sir. Okay, it's time. We're ready. Shoes are on. Alpha Flies. Got my headband for the sweat. It's about 40 degrees out, so it's still pretty chilly, but it's gonna be perfect once I get rolling. And yeah, 21K. 13.1 miles. Thankfully, I've recruited my mom to help out on the other end, so she's gonna pick me up down in Denver. Here we go, all right. I'm trying to think if there's anything else. Oh yeah, I've got the little camera. We'll see what we can get. Keep in mind, I'm gonna be running pretty darn fast, at least as fast as I hope I can go on this fine day, so I will see how much footage I can get for all of you. Oh, thanks for being here, thanks for watching. Come on now, 13.1.
Well, that's encouraging, ladies and gentlemen. Time trial in the books, as I posted on Strava. We'll put the Alpha Fly over here on the shelf. Oh my goodness, nerves were up. I will say, at the starting line, nerves were up, getting ready. Remember, I talked yesterday, actually last night, 10 days, about how that mental approach to time trials is something that I yearn for as a runner, those nerves, getting to the starting line, laced up, ready to rock and roll. So here's the deal though, I will say, if you incorporate a time trial into your training, especially during these strange times when no races are happening around the world, it's mentally challenging. The biggest challenge, 100%, is no competitors around you, right? It's amazing the power of competition and the human spirit and pushing each other out there on the course. Like it's second to none. Like, yes, not having cheering fans, that definitely is a factor. Not having aid stations along the way is a factor, but no doubt not having other runners around me to compete against was the biggest factor for today, as far as, okay, I gotta be really tuned in to my mental focus or else I'm not gonna do well out here. Now, as far as the course goes for today, this is my first time running the entire Cherry Creek path in my entire life. I've never done it from point to point, and it's beautiful. It's a great place to run. Again, shout out to the race directors for all the work they put into finding courses for us. I didn't know how much, I knew I would lose elevation. I wasn't sure how much because I've never run it before, but sure enough, I started out at 5,500 feet above sea level. Okay, there it is on your screen in meters. And then I ended up at 5,200 feet above sea level. So a drop of about 300 feet, all right? And I knew it was gonna drop because I was running along a creek that was, you know, going downhill. And then, holy smoke, so a lot of bridges, more bridges than I expected. Here's a shot of me turning onto a bridge, nice and sharp corners, so that kept me on my toes. I must say I had to really think about those sharp corners in the Alpha Flies. And in addition to the bridges, there were the underpasses. So probably went under a dozen roads where you dip down under the road and then you come up on the other side. So that added about 100 feet of elevation gain for the course. But overall, no stop signs, no stoplights. It really was perfect. Like there, I don't think I could have found a better point to point course in Denver, in a city. Anyway, I'm very pleased with the Cherry Creek path and the choice for the time trial today. Now let's jump into the results. I'll pull up Strava for all of you. Here we go. And it looks like I was able to hold a 5:08 per mile pace, or about 3:10 per kilometer. So coming out with a 1:07:20 for the final time. I'm pleased. I'm very pleased. I knew, okay, ahead of time though, I knew I was going to be close to that first half marathon time in Amsterdam. But what's crazy, I have not raced a road half marathon, I think, in 10 years. I'm actually going to try and go find the results when I was really out of shape. I decided to jump in a half marathon, and here's the results on your screen. So I put those results on your screen for you to tell, and that this race was in Denver, just so you know, so at elevation. But keep dreaming, keep working, keep fighting. That, again, I think it was about 10 years ago. I'll put it on your screen. There's my time, and now I'm 10 years older. And work, consistency, believing in yourself, but it's the long game. It's the marathon. You're not going to see results in 6 months. You're not going to see results in 1 year or two, or maybe even 2 years. Like, it takes dedication over years and years to develop, yes, that aerobic engine, that cadence. And yes, today's cadence, 194. Very pleased with that for my steps per minute out there on the Cherry Creek path. But I just want to drive home that point. I think I dropped about 10 minutes from 10 years ago. So keep working out there, keep fighting, and you will drop times. But it's all about that patience game. And one more point on the effort today before talking about the Alpha Flies is that I think my breathing was pretty good out there. It was peaking toward the end. You can see it on your screen right now. And I think those were the underpasses where I dipped down and then I'd have to go back up and dip down and go back up. So I think that's what those peaks were. But overall, breathing felt good. I am yearning to get back in a gym. My form, I just don't feel as in control as, let's say, a month ago. missing, I don't know, just the weights and the box jumps. I can do box jumps here at my house, but it's just different. It's not the same. So I'm missing the gym, and I was really trying to focus on my arm carriage and my foot strike today, and I did pretty well in the visualization of the whole the visualization when it started to hurt. But I must say, I got to stay focused over the next 3 weeks before the marathon time trial. Can you imagine? Where on earth, I don't know where I'm going to do a marathon time trial. If it's going to be the same location, but just go further out on the Platte River Trail, I'm not sure what's going to happen, but we will make it work together. Okay, here we go. The Alpha Flies, they're special, very special. I will say I'm having to lace up tighter and tighter every time I put these shoes on. So I think the Atom Knit upper material is stretching a little bit, so keep that in mind. Also, I'm just now, I think I'm at about, there it is on your screen, I think I'm about 45 miles in these shoes so far, and just now I'm starting to see some compression through the midsole, meaning creases, okay? So today's effort was hard, I was digging, and yes, I'm starting to see a little bit of compression there. They did great though, except for the sharp turns. Oh man, that was hard. I probably turned sharp one, two, three, probably three or four times where I literally did like a 90 degree turn. So that was a little challenging in these Alpha Flies. Okay, there you go, everyone. Question of the day. Have I piqued your interest in maybe incorporating a time trial into your training block, whether you're in the middle of a training block or the end of a training block? Because I think, again, as runners, getting out there and exerting your energy and just kind of getting the nerves out of the system, I think it's a really healthy thing, especially if you're used to doing running or racing and you can't do it right now. So that's the question of the day. Or part B, have you already done a time trial over the past, let's say, month, and how did it go for you? All right, there you go. Thanks for watching. Thanks for being here. Oh, it's fun. As you can tell, I'm jazzed up right now because I got to go just let it rip and butter the bread and butter the bread. All right, we're tossing it back to 2 weeks ago. I did the 23 mile long run in the Alpha Flies. Many of you have already seen that vlog, but if you haven't, you can go check it out right there. 23 mile long run. All right, everyone, you're the best. Seek beauty. Work hard and love each other. Thanks for being here. See you tomorrow.